I learned the game at the age of 10 when I was in primary 4. So back then, my primary school, which was no longer around, it was very famous for just one thing, and that's chess. So imagine a neighborhood school, you know, we have a bunch of future gang leaders, you know, very riotous, boisterous crowd of students, but playing chess. And chess was a huge equalizer for us. We have a very passionate teacher in charge who built up this close group of young players, and we somehow found it within ourselves to be competitive. You know, we attend chess club training every day, and very soon I became really competitive. I really wanted to win every game that I play, you know, against all of my peers, and to make sure that, you know, I'm, you know, some sort of an apex predator in the team, right? On my own, when I was a primary school kid, I took a train with a couple of my friends to literally every single public library that we know, just to borrow some books on chess. I got into a lot of trouble when I got home. My mom didn't believe that I was trying to learn something about chess. She just couldn't believe. She wanted me to admit that I was playing, you know, some catching or, you know, some more usual stuff that primary school kids like to do, and she didn't believe me, and then I got a good old-fashioned caning that day.
I am forever grateful to my commanding officer. Back then he was Lieutenant Colonel Lam Siu Tong, who allowed me time off to compete at the national championships, where I finished fifth. I won a team bronze medal, and obviously I was ecstatic, and I had something to brag about to my army mates.
I remember that was a particular year when I was right smack in the middle of a really important audio engagement, and I didn't really want to give up on that, and which I could have, but I didn't want to, and I still wanted to play a tournament of which there was a clash of dates. So what happened was, during that week, I had to, in order to meet my deadlines, I actually went without sleep for 40 hours. So we proceeded to play the first round of the Nationals, which I almost lost because I was so tired, right? I actually fell asleep during the game. I was diagnosed with obstructive sleep apnea, or OSA, and then the doctor just mentioned casually something about, you know, you might even want to consider a surgery. And I remember he said something like, if you go through this surgery, probably it will help you to increase your focus better. Will it help me play chess better, theoretically? And he just said, yeah, probably, in theoretical manner. And 3 weeks later, I got the surgery done. I wasn't really making a lot of progress at that time. And so I made a really difficult decision. And some would say, even now, some would say really impractical and crazy decision to take a one-year sabbatical from work. Considering that I was, at that time, one of the more promising audit seniors in my department, it wasn't, from a career perspective, it wasn't the most clever thing to do. 3 months into my sabbatical, I made my first grandmaster norm. When you have a sustained period of focus on any particular thing, you never know what kind of quantum leap that you might be able to experience. So I made my first GM norm in my sabbatical year. The effects of that training in that 1 year spilled over to the second year, and I made my second grandmaster norm. So now I have not made my third norm, but I've come close many times, and I still think that I can do it, you know. It's not over for me yet.
Could I do better with my life without chess? Probably not.